bud. How you doing?
My mom realized she hasn't had a single professional picture taken of my youngest son.
You guys aren't busy, are you?
Just make sure it's only 5 minutes. Hey, make sure it's on the screen though, so that they know.
Come, wise men go, will Herod let him live?
Mary Joseph,
better go to Egypt now.
That was a very clever original song. Good evening. Welcome to the 3rd Hill City Kids Christmas Pageant. We think so? Seems like 10. We are very thankful for all of you who are joining us. I'd like to welcome the internet. Everyone turn around and wave to the internet. Hi.
Hi, internet.
They're probably drinking hot chocolate and all those great things. My name is Aaron. I'm the pastor here. And this is my brother, Jordan. We used to star in many Christmas pageants together.
We?
You're right. Sorry. I used to star in many Christmas pageants while Jordan was in attendance. And we're thankful for the opportunity to reenact them all here tonight. So thank you for coming. Just kidding. We're going to sing a few Christmas carols while the kids get ready. So if you would, we're going to put the words on the screen. Will you stand and sing these familiar Christmas songs with us tonight?
And adore Christ, the everlasting God.
You can take a seat. Before we get started, we're gonna bring your kids out and they're gonna steal the show as is needed. But we'd like to say thank you. And normally when you say thank you to your teachers and your director, you give them a big bouquet of flowers, right? Well, we thought, it's 2020, everybody knows they're gonna need a little break after this, after spending time with our kids for the last 6 weeks learning the Christmas program. So as we bring your kids out, I'm gonna introduce you to the two people who really made this thing happen, and I'm gonna tell you that we're gonna give them a gift with a night out for them and their spouse that they can relax and enjoy the calm with no children. But before Before we do anything else, we'd like to say thank you to Miss Lisa. She's our kids director. Everyone give her a big, yeah. Do you want to turn around again, or? It's a beautiful blanket you have there. What's that called?
Be nice.
No, 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 what's this called?
Be nice.
What's it called?
Be nice Christmas, a sweater, a poncho, whatever, it's fashion, it's called
fashion. Wow. Let's be very clear, I was told to stall. This is first run through, we didn't get a practice, 2020. And this is my mom, Miss Grandma Cheryl. Everyone give it up for Grandma Cheryl. They've worked really hard. Part of the presentation tonight will be on video. Part of it will be live. We're all just trying as best we can here, people. So if you wind up watching part of a Monty Python video, just roll with it, all right? Huh? We will take care of that. All right, here we go.
Here. Oh, we have, oh, well, nice. Did you get a new face mask, Paul?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you're looking good today.
Yes, sir.
Oh. What?
Yes, sir.
Well, are you trying to welcome everybody? Yeah, okay, that's what I'll do then, okay? So, they don't really understand you, it's okay. So, Paul would like to give a warm welcome to the Hill City Christmas Pageant. So without further ado, I think you need to go find Jasper because he's got stuff to do. No, go find Jasper. No, look, you do have, no, Jasper's got things to do. Go get, like, he's the.
We can't understand you, Paul.
He's the narrator, get him.
Paul, we can't understand you. Shh, take off the mask. Paul, take off the mask. Paul. He left. Sorry about that. I'll take over for Paul, don't mind. Let's see here. Every who down in Whoville liked Christmas.
Jasper.
Have you ever wondered what we might see if we could pull back the curtain of time so that to the very first Christmas, if we could imagine the story began in heaven, something like this. God was looking over heaven's gate one day, shaking his head at all the wrong things people were doing down on the earth.
It might look like this.
This isn't quite what I had in mind when I created the Earth. I feel so far away from my kids down there.
I see what you're saying. Things look pretty out of control down there. Sorry, God. What are you thinking?
It's just hard to be friends with people when you don't like what they're doing. I've been thinking.
Thinking what, Lord?
I think it's time.
Time for what, Lord?
Time for us to step in.
I agree, Lord. What are you thinking?
Maybe just one person.
One person?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
No, I don't think we should send an army. Maybe just one person.
A newborn baby?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that! This plan is rather risky.
A baby is small and weak.
Someone must protect him.
Maybe a great ruler.
Maybe a mighty king.
Maybe a mighty king.
Lord, this sounds like a good plan. I will start putting together a list of mighty kings and great rulers now. You can pick the best of the best.
Actually, I was thinking about sending him to a peasant girl whose heart is beautiful and full of courage.
A peasant girl!
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that. This will be a big surprise!
No one will be expecting a newborn baby born to a humble villager, but Lord, what can a baby do?
Yeah, what can a baby do?
This will not be any baby, for I am sending the Prince of Heaven in disguise.
The Prince of Heaven?
Our Prince?
Your son?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that.
Thank you.
too risky. Sending the prince in disguise as a tiny baby, born not to kings but to humble villagers? I agree.
Surely a prince cannot be born in a cottage.
He just can't. It would not be right.
He must be born in a palace.
It's only right, Lord. You are all right. He should not be born in a cottage.
He will be born in a stable.
A what?
A stable? So unsanitary.
Surrounded by animals?
Can you even imagine that?
Filled with hay?
Filled with poop?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, I don't want to sound disrespectful, but this all seems rather uncertain. We have so many questions. Lord, how will all the people know he is there?
What if they don't notice him?
So many what ifs.
I promise those who are looking will find him, and his mission will bring all people closer to me, even if they have done something really wrong. When the prince is done, nothing will get between them and my love.
Lord, we trust you. That all is wonderful. Sounds like the answer to all our questions.
Can we leave some clues for the people looking?
Like in the stars?
Clues in the stars? Sure, why not? We can make one big one that points to him.
I love stars. I would follow a star.
Jasper, are you there? How are you doing? Aren't these kids doing a great job telling
the... They're adorable, yes.
They are adorable. They are telling the greatest story ever told, okay? We have one more little bit of this movie. So we're gonna get all settled in, and we're gonna just see how this story ends. Are we ready?
Spoiler alert, I know how it ends.
Shh, go.
This is
traveled from afar,
spoiler for the rest of the story, an angel visited a humble girl with a courageous heart and told her the good news. She would have a baby, and he would be the Prince of Heaven, who would help all the earth to be close to God again. As planned, the baby was born in a stable, about as far from a palace as you can get. A group of wise men noticed some strange clues in the stars. They packed up all their stuff and followed that star in search of the infant king. And of course, a bunch of lonely shepherds were guarding their sheep when all of a sudden, the sky lit up with thousands of angels singing. It was brilliant. And no one expected that.
My goodness. Sarah, way to explore the space. Just one more time, give it up for him. You know, we love to do this. My mom's been doing stuff like this for 30 plus years, and the idea that it wasn't gonna happen this year because of all the craziness just didn't sit right with us. And so the video part, my wife filmed and edited. You can all turn around and wave and smile at her, say thank you. We've had lovely assistants back in the kids' rooms, Abby and Ingrid and other, who we got here? Ellie and Lori are right here. We are just so thankful for all of their work and that this has happened. We'd love to let you know that you can watch it again and again and again on YouTube and Facebook. So if you want to see Henry, where are you, buddy? Henry, come here, bud. Come here. One more time, what's that line?
Really? They won't be expecting that.
Thank you so much for joining us. We had over 30 people watching on YouTube and Facebook as well. I want to say thank you to them. I'm going to say a prayer, and then on the way out, there are ice cream treats and all sorts of goodies individually wrapped. But we're gonna let your kids go first after they run back and take off all of their costumes, all right? We're gonna pray and then, Sarah. No, that's cool, that's how my kids treat me too. Okay, here we go. Heavenly Father, we're just so thankful for this night and the celebration of these kids as they remember your birth into this world and celebration of you coming to bring us hope and joy and love and peace. God, we thank you for all those who are watching, whether here in person or online. We thank you for the joy of celebrating Christmas together. And God, we just ask for your blessing to be upon us as your children as we go from this place and we remember that you cared for us so much that you sent your son, Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us, to come and to save us. And the world wasn't expecting him to come the way he did, God, but your perfect plan just played out, and we're so thankful that it did. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for coming. Your kids can go back and take off their costumes. If you want to join us at 4:30 on Christmas Eve, you're welcome to do that as well. Thank you. Merry Christmas.